This is the Bob and Tom Show. Thanks very much for joining us. We're dropping the needle on 80s stuff in honor of our guest, Cristela Alonso. Cristela, I can't tell you why we're enjoying this so much. It would be sexist if we mentioned the...
You are something else.
Well, I'm not just stating the obvious. Cristela is endowed with many gifts.
Thanks.
Why are you looking at me, Christy?
Thanks.
Cristela is over there dancing, and I was
having
just remarking
yeah,
on the...
there's nothing wrong with her dancing.
On her protruding attributes.
He means my personality.
Uh-huh. That's right.
You're
both
lovely,
of them.
You're a lovely one.
Ladies and gentlemen, what you're listening to is Tom...
talking up the ladies.
Working on the ladies.
Now you've got that surprised look on your face, like, oh, what's that? Okay, let's switch gears here. I believe we have, the great actor Mark Wahlberg about to join us on the phone
in 1 minute.
Okay, we'll look forward to talking with Mark. He was
there
in a great movie called The Fighter. Oh, this is Mark right now.
Mark,
hey guys,
how you doing?
How are you? How are you? Good morning.
Good. We are great, thanks.
What a switch going from The Fighter to a movie with a talking bear.
It's pretty crazy.
Yeah. Yes, it is.
I saw the preview. It looks very, very funny. I assume that when you do all the stuff with all the technical aspects of it, the bear's not there with you much?
No, he was very difficult.
I never had the luxury of meeting the bear.
He was very difficult in his trailer most of the day.
In the fight scene is really, it's very realistic. Did you fight another guy at the time?
Crazy, but I never actually...
Yeah.
No, I didn't. I just had, sometimes it would just be me. Sometimes they'd give me like two paws to hold on to.
Okay. I'm going to see the movie now.
Uh-huh. Yeah,
this is too ridiculous, guys. We're crossing the line here. But it's one of the most talked about scenes in the movie.
Well, someone said that they compared it to like one of the fight scenes in The Bourne Identity.
Yeah, it's crazy. I just read a review where they said it's the fight scene of the year.
All because you call him Teddy Ruxpin.
No.
I never felt more ridiculous. One thing you don't call Ted is Teddy Ruxpin.
Mm-hmm. When you do it, is someone doing his dialogue for you on the set, or are you just out there on your own?
Well, that was a good thing. Seth MacFarlane, who does the voice, also directed the film, so he'd be there on set doing the voice.
Mm-hmm.
But you would just basically be looking at nothing, or they'd have a stick with a couple of dots on it for the eyes.
A couple of bear eyes.
Yeah, so... You know, it was a little nerve-wracking at first, but then I found myself enjoying it because I didn't have to deal with another, you know, pansy actor.
Nothing worse.
Now, we were lucky enough to...
I was the only one in the room worried about my makeup.
We were lucky enough to talk to you when you made The Fighter, when you were promoting The Fighter, which was an amazing movie.
Oh, thank you.
And obviously, the level of dedication that you put into that film, you know, I know it was a work from your heart, but from the physicality, the workouts, the exercise, this movie clearly a little different.
Yeah.
Yeah, this movie was so funny because I had the real Johnny Drama saying, dude, you got to start smoking weed again. I could be the weed consultant.
That's right.
You know, I said, dude, I remember what it was like, dude. I don't need to really do it.
Oh, it's great.
Now, when you're making a film, do you have to try to remember funny things that happened? Because I know right now you're publicizing the film Ted, and obviously you made it quite a while back, and sometimes it's hard to remember funny small things about the movies. Does someone help you go, hey, remember when this happened so you've got stuff to talk about?
No, that was such a memorable experience.
I was going to say, you don't forget a bear.
Yeah, remember,
honestly,
I did the
so
show.
Fun.
Mm-hmm.
Seth MacFarlane, who's probably the most successful guy I've ever been around,
mm-hmm.
He's talented, he's, you know, rich, but he's such a funny guy and such a sweet guy that you actually find yourself going to work early just to kind of hang around him.
Mm-hmm.
So every day was a joy to make the movie. You
when they approach you with this, though, didn't they, did you, like, you want to do what?
No, I thought it was the dumbest idea I'd ever heard.
Yeah, okay.
I'm telling you. And then I read the script, and I was like, oh, my God, I get it. And then I met with him,
right.
And I signed on, and then I went home to tell my wife, hey, I'm doing this movie about a talking teddy bear. And all of a sudden, my tune changed, and she goes, that's the dumbest idea ever. And it's going to ruin your career.
Uh-huh.
And now she literally saw the movie the first cut, flew her father out to see the next cut, took all my premiere tickets to give to her friends. And I'm like, Dave, this is a business thing. You can't have all your friends at the premiere. Like, this isn't like Sex and the City here. But,
uh-huh.
You know, she just loved it. So it was like, you know, one of those things where she's, you know, been promoting the movie more than me.
We're speaking with Mark.
Crazy premise, but the movie is awesome. So
sorry, I want to reintroduce our guest. It's Mark Wahlberg, the very fine actor, and the movie he's talking about, Ted, is about a talking teddy bear. And, I want to say it's a very adult film.
It is a hard R.
It's a hard R.
It has some humor and sexual content that is not appropriate for children under seven.
Uh-huh. Yeah, I just want to say, because I'm the father of many, and I know you are as well. You just have to be careful. I'm the guy that took his kids to see Bad Santa.
Because it had Santa in the title.
Oh, I'm sorry. I apologize, Mark. I want to protect all of the parents. Do not take your kids to see Ted.
Hey, one of the great movies of all time, Bad Santa, but I'm telling you, my kids, they see the posters in L.A. of Daddy and the Teddy Bear.
Yeah.
I'm like, Dad, we've never seen any movies. We've got to be able to see this one. It's you and the Teddy Bear. What can be so bad about it? Mm-hmm. And then I go to the school. I take them to school, and the kids in the upper grades are like, dude, we can't wait to see Ted, man. And my kids are like, what's going on? Now, me, personally, I wouldn't mind taking my sons to it, right?
Mm-hmm.
My wife would chop my head off. But it was the only thing she would chop off. Yeah. You notice how I started whispering because my wife's in the other room.
She must be in the other room.
Sure. Mark Wahlberg is our guest. Congratulations, by the way, on the great success of Entourage.
Thank you.
Wonderful program.
Doug Ellen is in the middle of writing the screenplay right now, so we'll have the movie hopefully in theaters next summer.
That was my next question. Will you be in the movie or just producing it or what?
Well, I'm definitely producing it, but I, you know, if they want me or need me in it, I'm in it for sure.
Okay.
So that's I don't know much about
Hollywood. Since you're the producer, can't you make them put you in?
I think you can write yourself in, can't you?
Yeah, but, you know, I'm the kind of producer who I want to put everybody else in the front. I mean, I love being in the background. I don't need to kind of, you know, but if it's needed or necessary or makes sense, then I would love to be in it, but I don't, you know, I'm a very gracious guy. I like to see other people, you know, hold the spotlight. I've always kind of, like, tried to, as a producer, spend more time behind the scenes. It allows me to spend more time at home with my family and my kids.
Mm-hmm.
You know,
have you ever done a cameo in a movie that
being
you...
Being famous is only really cool when you're single, dude.
Have you ever been in a movie where you did a cameo and weren't credited?
Where
you're in the background and people would not know that?
Hmm.
No.
Oh, okay. Sometimes, you know, people sneak in. Might be in disguise. Hey, by the way, I want to say a top 10 movie ever made, The Shooter.
Thank you.
One of the best
one of my favorites.
Action movies ever.
Yeah.
That's one of my favorites. You know, people come up to you, you know, and talk about random movies. That's usually one that's really high on the list.
That's it. Really is a great movie.
Well, the new movie is called Ted, and I believe it was described by our guest as a hard R, which is sort of hard to say when you have kind of a Boston accent.
So that'd be like a light X, right?
Yeah. I'm laughing at both comments at the same time.
Well, Mark, it's a great pleasure. We certainly want to thank you for all the great work you've done. We really love your movies. And best of luck with Ted.
Thanks, guys. I appreciate it.
Sure.
Thanks, Mark.
That's my hard R.
Hard R, kids.
There's a Red Band trailer, is what they call it, for the uncensored trailers on the internet. You need.
Good yeah, I'd imagine Stepper's kid seeing his dad up there with a big teddy bear. And
For the thunder song alone, probably.
Yeah. The teddy bear is a very salty language.
He has an attitude,
it's called
dude.
Ted.
Yeah, and he also has some issues with maybe some substance abuse.
He might.
Okay, let's get back to our guest. We have a new guest in the studio.
Yes, we do.
We have Cristela Alonso.
Hello.
Female Latina. And then we have Dave Williamson, the whitest guy in the room. Blue eyes.
No.
Blue
no,
eyes,
no,
blonde hair.
He almost looks like he's black compared to you, Tom.
You guys are jumping to conclusions. I am also a female Latina.
My apologies.
A little offended.
You know who he reminds, and I don't know what it, and I don't, have you been in movies that I played, you
Several
played a bad guy?
Famous.
You played a bad guy in any of the movies? Because he's got this look that I immediately don't like.
Oh, really?
And the last time this happened...
Starting great.
Yeah, the last time this happened, it was the bad guy from the Kevin James movie where he's mall cop. I think it was...
Adam Ferrara. Yeah.
Or somebody like... Yeah, and I'm like, you're just a...
You look like a young, waspy super dude.
Young waspy Super Dave?
Yeah, you know Super Dave Osborne?
Yeah, Bob Einstein. Yeah.
You guys are rewriting my bio.
This is radio. People can't see him. Am I right, though, Christy?
Well,
kind of an Irish-y...
Don't you think you could cast him as the bully in the high school?
Marty Funkheiser Jr.
Yeah.
There you go. All right.
Villain in the Karate Kid.
There you go.
Exactly.
That's
right. Karate Kid.
He's tall, blonde, blue eyes. He could be your son.
Sweep the leg! Do you have a problem with that?
Do it for Johnny. Do it for Johnny.
I'm not that tough, though, man. Wax on, wax off for me would be more about getting your eyebrows waxed or something, I think.
Wax off for most of our guests.
For most of our listeners, it's a morning in the bathroom.
Yeah. Yeah, they're looking at Christella on the internet.
Oh. Dancing.
Oh, my God. What happened?
I like the Latina. Show me the Latina.
Hear him? He's got game.
You got to be careful.
Chris Walt's still got game.
Latina women have a hot temper, Tom.
Really?
Be careful. Oh, yes.
That's the stereotype. Ooh, you have a hot temper?
No, yeah, I do.
Really? You throw stuff?
Yeah, I do.
You throw stuff?
I'll tell you. I don't throw stuff, but I'll fight someone for like a friend or something. I'll do it.
Atta
I'll
girl.
Throw it down. Yeah. I'll throw it down.
You throw down.
If anybody ever said anything bad about you guys, I would fight them for it, to defend your honor.
I would just have strong words for them.
Okay.
And it would start with look, and Mister would be in there somewhere. Yeah.
Let's find out about Dave. Dave, where are you from?
Miami, Florida.
Okay. Oh,
don't mention the heat. I don't want to hear about it.
Yeah, let's talk about it.
Oh, yeah. You know, this is our second fair-skinned, light-haired guy from Florida who doesn't seem like you fit the bill for Florida.
Who's the other guy?
Greg Hahn.
Oh, yeah. Mm-hmm.
Okay.
You guys,
a trend.
Yeah, it looks like you have to dodge the sun wherever you are in Florida.
I do. Story of my life.
Mm-hmm.
Very freckly.
Mm-hmm.
Well, you know, when I go on acting auditions in Miami, there's only like four of us down there. So it's pretty much the same four white guys we call for every role that fits the bill.
And the one guy got the CSI Miami. Now there's three of you.
Exactly.
And that just got canceled.
Well, that's a good point.
David Caruso.
Yeah, they didn't film that in Miami anyways. That was all in LA.
Oh, weird.
Mm-hmm.
They deserve it.
Yes.
That wasn't none of that was filmed in Miami?
Very little.
Outdoor
little stock,
scenes.
Little stock footage.
Yeah. Are you serious?
Town, and most of it was filmed in L.A.
Well, no wonder.
Well, no wonder. People in Miami are pissed.
You're crushed.
Man. Yeah, we're really upset.
Well, if I'd ever sat through more than the first 30 seconds of the show, I'd be crushed, but I never actually watched it.
I didn't realize the Hollywood Wax Museum was in Miami. Who knew?
We're going to find out more about our guest.
We have to take a break.
But first, this portion of the Bob and Tom Show brought to you by
The Dish Network. Do you subscribe to Dish? Well, you should. They're the best TV provider out there, and they have the best technology, and the Karate Kid's playing somewhere
That's right.
I'm guessing Dish's new whole home HD DVR called The Hopper has primetime anytime.
The Hopper.
It lets you automatically record four networks of primetime TV all at once, and all you have to do is push one button. You don't have to do much of anything else. Just press that one button, and HD primetime TV automatically recorded and saved your DVR for up to 8 days. Call Dish at 1-800-WATCH-TV. Dish, let's watch TV.
Dish. Thank you very much, Dish. We'll come back and find out about
Dave.
Dave, I'm trying to think. We need a nickname for him.
A nickname?
Do you wear a karate suit on stage?
I should. I'm going to start now.
Okay, good.
What is with
it? It's a theme.
We'll be right back. This is the Bob and Tom Show. This is the Bob and Tom Show.
Great song.
I love this song.
Once again, we are dropping the needle in honor of our guest, Christella Alonzo, who keeps dancing while seated. And we're enjoying this very much. You have to let that rocket drop. Rock the Casbah. The oil down the desert way. Have to shake it to the top. Notice the white guys aren't dancing?
The
shake it to the
top. The Latinas. Because we can.
I got the rhythm.
This is me dancing right now.
Again, with us in the studio.
Good moves. Great moves, Dave.
Yeah.
Dave Williamson is the white guy from Miami.
You know, he looks like a Dave Williamson.
Dave Williamson.
Oh, my mom got it right.
How are you?
I'm Dave Williamson.
Dave, know nothing about you. You're from Miami, and you're kind of blondish, light-eyebrowed guy. Probably can't be in the sun at all. Are you married, single? What's happening in your life?
Oh, I'm very married, yeah. Happily married to my college sweetheart.
Oh, aww. Is that right?
Yeah. Are you guys awing that I went to college?
Oh, come on. You didn't say you graduated. He just said it was his college sweetheart. Could have met her in the freshman year. And
that's true.
I'm sorry.
Children?
I have two boys.
Oh, wow. Wow.
Two sons, a two-year-old and a five-year-old.
Ah, good.
Uh-huh.
Yeah, very cool, man. I love having boys.
Mm-hmm.
I don't think I would be able to properly raise a girl in this society. I'm very sensitive. I'm one of those guys that would be up till 3 in the morning waiting for her to get home.
Mm-hmm.
I can't believe I just admitted I would probably have a daughter that would be out till 3 in the morning.
Yeah. Now what the hell is she doing breaking?
I don't know. I'm mad at her. She doesn't even exist right now.
And she's only five.
Yeah, not even five. Mm-hmm.
Oh, that's right. Yeah, she hasn't even born yet.
No.
Okay. Mm-hmm. Okay. Well, congratulations on the boys. What are their names?
Carter and Owen.
Owen. Okay. Ooh. I like that name.
Strong names.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah.
Yeah. Yeah. Judge names.
That's what we were going for.
Owen.
Judge Owen Williamson today sentenced a Chick McGee to 15 years.
What the hell did I do?
Sorry. What haven't you done?
Owen, you just pissed Owen off. Sorry. Yeah,
my kids are finally going to take you down, Chick.
Mm-hmm.
Okay. Now, what else is going on? Let's see. Oh, you're from Miami. The Heat just won. You want to gloat about that for a minute or two?
I do. Let's do it. Let's have a little cocky Heat fan moment here.
All right, over.
That's it.
Done.
That's
it. Done.
Hope you enjoyed your parade. God,
you were so obnoxious there.
What a braggart.
Jeez. There's nothing I could do that you guys wouldn't be okay with it, though, man. Like, the whole country hates us, so we might as well just go with it.
No, we don't hate you. We hate LeBron James.
Okay. No, it's just
that's us. Really, I don't know if you're aware, but that's our team.
The, the entire country was rooting for Oklahoma.
Oklahoma. Underdog,
right.
Great kid,
oh, yeah.
Young team.
Right.
You know, formerly Seattle. You've got a lot going for you.
It would have been big.
Them.
Oh, yeah.
Yeah, of course. Yeah. It's a great love story. You know, it's like it's Rudy. Right. Rudy of the
Rudy.
NBA.
Guys, I'm also a Dolphins fan, so can you just throw me a bone on that?
Mm-hmm. That's who you look like. You look like the Dolphins' new quarterback.
Yeah.
That's who you look like.
Yeah, what's his name? One of the 25 we've had since Marino. But yeah, man, it was a fun season down there. I actually took my son to a Heat game this year.
Uh-huh.
And
the five-year-old?
The five-year-old. Yeah, I took him too. Because we watch on TV a lot, and he gets really into it and everything. So I decided I was going to take him to a game. But I actually ended up taking him to a University of Miami basketball game.
Uh-huh.
I just told him it was a Heat game. Cause
well, you're the best dad in the world.
Wow. That money is his college fund there. All right? Those tickets are expensive. I don't know if you guys are aware of that.
Very yes, they are.
Come apart.
Mm-hmm.
But he didn't know the difference.
He didn't know the difference, yeah.
You just got to play it up a little bit. Like, there goes LeBron. Look at him.
They're in their throwback uniforms, son.
And a years later,
spry.
What did they change the colors?
Throwbacks.
Yeah, no, exactly. Actually, that's a funny story, man.
Uh-huh.
My son, like, when we watch the games, he doesn't always remember which team to root for.
Oh, okay. Mm-hmm. Sure.
So we break it down, like, all right, well, that's the red team based on uniform color,
mm-hmm.
and that's the green team,
mm-hmm.
and then we'll say that's the good guys, and that's the bad guys. And we were watching the UM game, and UM was playing Wake Forest.
Mm-hmm.
He was wearing black uniforms that day.
Mm-hmm.
And my son decided to stand up during a particularly quiet point in the game.
Uh-oh.
And just with all the passion of a sports fan, he screamed, "We don't like the black guys."
Wow.
I start
freaking out.
No
man.
Doubt.
Like, no one knows our little system. You know?
Uh-huh.
Like, even the dude dribbling the ball just stopped and looked up at our section. Like, yeah. Seriously?
No doubt.
I'm like, no, buddy. We love everybody.
Mm-hmm. We can't take him to Hooters anymore.
No.
Well, that's okay.
Yeah. Watching this
rough.
Yeah.
That is rough. We're talking with comedian Dave Williamson, also with us in the studio, Cristela Alonso. Cristela, you live in Los Angeles, California.
Yes, I do.
The founding state of medical marijuana.
Yes.
Are you a marijuana gal? You don't appear to be.
No,
you don't
have that look. You know, to me, it's like, I get it, but it's like, I have this theory. I tried weed once in college, and it just slows everything down. And I'm like, if you have a crappy life, the last thing you need is to put that sucker in slow motion. You know, it's like, why would you do that? You know, everybody, and then now you've got the synthetic weed where people are gnawing people's faces off and stuff. You're like, what, you know?
Yeah, that was
my backyard.
Oh, that's right. That's right.
What happened to Cheetos? Huh?
What happened to Cheetos?
I love Cheetos.
They took munchies to the next level.
That's going to have Cheetos than a face.
I mean, Cheetos, tuna fish, and grape jelly. Whoa.
Come on. Nose is a delicacy down there.
Wow.
Face tartar.
Mm-hmm.
Not happy.
No.
So let's talk about your life. Now, do you live in an apartment or a house?
Apartment.
With your boyfriend?
Yes.
He lives there with you?
Yes.
Okay. Do you cook at all?
Yes. I cook. I clean. You know, it's that thing
what kind
where
of food,
like...
Do you have any special dishes that you're really good at?
I only do like very extensive like Mexican food.
Really?
Yeah. I make the beans that takes like 4 hours to make. I do like the extensive soup that takes hours to make, like the caldo and everything. The tortillas we do by hand. I mean, I do everything and
you are quite a catch.
Well, you know, it's that thing where I think my mom was very old school. The thing where she always wanted me to take care of the guy.
Mm-hmm.
So it's like with my two older brothers, I always had to cater to my brothers, you know. So if my brothers wanted something to drink, I would have to go get it for them.
Oh my.
You know, it's like that kind of thinking.
Right.
And my mom always said, you can have a career, but always make sure that you cook and clean at home. You know, it's just that old thinking. And
I'm surprised you don't have four or five comedians living with you.
Amen.
Well, now that they've heard this, you're
yeah. I know. I'm a nerdy chick that likes to cook and clean.
Mm-hmm.
What's your favorite movie?
Of all time, I got to say Goodfellas, probably. I love Goodfellas.
Great movie.
Great
Goodfellas
movie.
Is great. Star Wars is awesome. And
and you are wearing, once again, a comic book, a Justice League of America t-shirt.
Justice League. Mm. I love it.
Did you like the Avengers?
Avengers blew my mind. I did the midnight showing, and I was really upset because I was sitting in front of these girls that... They were just these annoying girls. They're like, whatever. This is so dumb. Oh, boring. Like, this is stupid. And I remember the thing that really like pissed me off is that the girl was like, what do you expect? They're all losers. Which I was like, you don't talk. Like, to me, it's like you never say that anyone's a loser for liking anything.
Mm-hmm.
Everybody's entitled to like whatever they want. So I turned around and I was like, I never want to hear from you for the rest of the movie. If I do, I'm going to see you outside. And it was that thing where she didn't expect that I was going to be sitting in front of her. The hot, you know, the hot-tempered Latina that loves comic books. I loved it. I can't wait. I have tickets for the Batman movie coming up. I bought it like, you know, the moment they came out like a month ago.
Good Lord.
We have a survey on our website, and that appears to be the one everyone wants to see. Also in the studio, Dave Williamson. Dave, obviously a father of two, probably not a big marijuana guy. You don't have time to be traveling like that, I assume.
That's daddy's special time.
Don't bother daddy, boys.
No, I've never been a big drug guy. I enjoy a nice cold beer or 10 from time to time.
Not a boy.
Perfectly legal and
I
acceptable.
Love beer. Mm-hmm.
Are you a gadget guy?
Who isn't?
I agree. Who isn't?
Yeah, I mean,
you got a really nice. I can't see over there. You have an iPhone.
Nice. I'm addicted to my iPhone, but you know, I'm a little scared of cell phones these days, though, man. Like, I'm convinced that cell phones are the cigarettes of our generation.
Mm.
Like, I guarantee 20 years from now, our kids are all going to be grown up and staring at us like, are you serious, Dad? Are you for real? You guys never knew that those things were killing you?
Mm-hmm.
They emit radiation. You were holding them up next to your brain for 2 hours out of the day, idiot.
Mm-hmm.
The other 8 or 9 hours, you had it in your pocket touching your junk. Are you serious? How is that not obvious?
Uh-huh.
But by then, we're addicted, so we're all walking around with droid patches on and chewing iPhone gum.
Wow. Only place you can use one is in the Veterans Hall.
Yeah. I'm down to 18.
They've been banned everywhere
else.
Can't
even use one outside.
Yeah. Lucky I'm a vet.
Mm-hmm. It's going to happen.
Give me your digits, baby.
I joined the VFW just so I could use my phone.
Oh, my God. He's lost his mind.
Bob and Tom Show.
Hey, hi, guys. It's me, Bill Clinton.
Oh, hi, Bill.
How's everybody?
Oh, we're great.
Hey, I like Crystal in there. Crystal, you're a stripper, huh?
It's Christella. It's not Crystal. She's not a stripper. She's a writer and a comedian.
Okay. All Crystals I know are strippers.
No, this is Christella.
I'm sorry.
Very sweet girl.
I know she is. I'm sorry.
And we know what you want.
You know what I want. That's exactly right.
Hey, Bill, did you hear about the, there's a photograph of you? What was it? Where is it? At some castle?
Yeah, I did.
In Ireland.
Yeah, you were just,
It was outstanding, man. I'm over there and, you know, I saw this hot chick anyway. Her name was Kelly Seaman, so right off the bat, I wanted to talk to her.
Of course.
Yeah. She married this guy, Patrick Howard, but I said to the bride, I said an Irish prayer for her.
Oh, did you?
Well, you know, we're over there in Ireland and everything, and I've got an Irish background.
Uh-huh.
May the road rise up to meet you. May the wind always be at your backside.
Uh-huh.
May your husband fall off a cliff shortly so I can bang you tonight.
Oh,
it went something like that.
Cheers.
She said that's not exactly how it went, but I asked her if she'd ever seen the Barney Stone. She said no.
Mm-hmm.
And I said, well, you want to kiss it?
I tell you, you have all the moves, Bill.
I got every one of them. Then I played golf. Then I played golf down in Kinsale at a course called the Old Head.
Uh-huh. You're having the time of your life.
Are you kidding me? I mean, it was like the perfect storm. I've got a woman named Seaman. I'm playing golf with Old Head.
Oh, God.
Prayers, asking to bang her.
It's good, Bill. Thank you. He's got to go. Woman's name is Seaman. He said.
Yeah.
Oh, I get it.
Yeah, he has.
He has
a good time, doesn't he?
Yes, he does.
If you're going to be an ex-president, I think he's the one.
He loves life.
Man.
He's the one. He's the one to be. We're talking with our guests, Cristela Alonso. Cristela, you sound like you're very good at lots of different things. Dave, you sound like you're good at being a dad.
borderline.
And nothing
borderline.
After that? Is that what you're trying to say?
That was an insult.
And, and you're very funny on stage. I know that. I just meant that what else do you do?
You did not save it.
What else do you do? I'm surprised you're going. What do you do for a living?
No, I mean, what else did you do? Do you
knit? What?
There you go. No, I do hobbies.
Any hobbies?
Yeah, I enjoy breathing.
That a boy?
You don't smoke. You drink a few beers occasionally.
Yeah, man. I'm a big water polo guy, actually. Surprisingly enough.
Really?
Huh. Yeah, man. I played water polo in college, and I coach high school now and stuff.
There you go.
See, there's a sport.
Didn't you play water polo, Bob?
I did until the horse drowned.
Yeah. Gotta keep his head. One of the classics. Gotta keep his head up.
One of the classics. Thank you very much.
I'm still wearing his Speedo, too. So I'm geared up for the Olympics. Looking forward to that.
Is there water polo in these Olympics?
There is, man, yeah.
Mm-hmm. I didn't know
that. It's the only time that water polo is...
recognized.
Yeah. You can see it anywhere.
Well, we found out what's not in the Olympics this year.
What? And that is?
Well, there's no croquet.
No.
Oh, I'm devastated.
The tennis is back.
Mm-hmm.
Baseball's gone.
Golf's gone. Golf's coming in, the next Olympics.
It's confusing.
Mm-hmm.
But there's swimming and diving, track and field.
Yeah.
Basketball, so there will be a new dream team.
Yes.
Nice.
And apparently, is LeBron playing? Is that the latest?
He is. Yeah, he is. Wade is not. LeBron
Wade,
is.
Yeah, Wade is.
Is there sailing in this one? Wasn't there sailing a little?
That's what LeBron's going to be doing, sailing, actually.
He's quite the boatsman. All right.
Mix up the athletes. Make them do sports.
Make them do other things?
Yes.
Yeah, make LeBron do gymnastics.
Yeah.
That'd be great.
Yeah. He could walk over the parallel bar, couldn't he?
Probably. He's a tall man.
Mm-hmm.
So what else is interesting in your life?
The most prominent thing going on in my life right now is I actually just recently rented out my house.
Oh.
And I bought a 25-foot travel trailer. And decided that I was really going to go after this whole comedy touring thing. And my wife and kids and I are traveling the country, U.S. and Canada, for 4 months so that they can go with me. Because, you know, before, it was like I was getting really excited that the comedy thing was going well for me. But it was kind of like my success was also like, oh, but you're going out of town again, you know? Like, we're happy you booked something, but you're leaving for three or
leave
four
days. Leaving
again. So you got them with you?
So, yeah, man. Yeah, they're
do they need to come in and use the bathroom or anything?
They're sleeping in the parking lot.
That's
I hope
right.
They don't mind.
Leave them out in the parking lot.
My mom's right, okay. actually, at, or my my wife's emptying our poop tank right now. I hope you don't mind. So man, they're traveling the whole country.
That's interesting. That sounds like National Lampoon stand-up vacation.
It does. Sounds like fun.
I invested in a very nice video camera, and I'm documenting every minute of it that I can.
Who drives?
Fantastic.
I drive. Mm-hmm. My wife drove for 40 minutes and decided that I'll be driving the entire...
It's a little too big? Yeah.
Uh-huh. It's a whole other animal. And I'm not good at driving the thing by any means, so...
You're driving a house.
Yeah.
Have you driven into anything with the roof being higher, like, for example, a drive-through or... Do you remember that you can't go through a drive-thru?
Yeah, I've had some close calls, but nothing too
No, I'm bad. Only saying this because I...
It happens.
I have done it. I used to have a bicycle rack that went on the roof of my car.
Uh-oh.
And then I drove
in
my garage.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah, you remember this? I drove
in
my garage.
Oh, that's right. You drove in your garage, much like Chevy Chase did with the suitcases in vacation.
Sure, so, yeah, I can't have... And I had this thing you buy that you hang it on your mirror and it says... whatever, gear up or something, reminding you that you have stuff there, which I was reminded that when the sound of the bicycles crushing against the wall.
Oh, well, it worked.
Yeah. No, I never drive. Yeah. I would get in an RV and drive under a low bridge or something.
I definitely have a history with that. I'm sure it'll happen. Just hasn't happened yet. I went through a car wash in a customer's car at a car dealership one time with a bike rack on the top and pulled it up, and the bike rack looked like a transformer on the top of it. It was ripped up. And the customer's like, what happened? I'm like, your car's ready. What do you mean, what happened? I'm like, oh, no.
Oh, boy.
And then actually the day before we left to go on this trip, as I was moving out of my house, I had purchased a moving van, you know, to move all my stuff out.
Mm-hmm.
And I pulled up in the storage unit place, and I totally nailed the awning over the door with the moving truck. I mean, just nailed it. I'm like, all right, well, the next 4 months in an RV should be good.
No problem.
Yeah, getting this started off on a good foot.
Wait a minute. Don't you think that a storage place should have an awning higher than the moving trucks because people are moving all the time?
You would think. It wasn't really in a place that so much you hit it with a truck. I just figured out a way to do it.
Oh, okay.
It was kind of off to the side. And
it's
I was
way off to the side, away from the roadway. Mm-hmm. Wow.
See, but you're close to being able to do what Tom does. It's not your fault you ran into the awning.
No.
It's the storage company's fault for putting the awning
right.
too low.
Exactly.
There you go. Yeah.
It's the awning doing there.
Rubbing off.
Well, but seriously. You have a place where people are moving constantly. That's what they
And they're probably driving rental trucks all the time.
Of course. Mm-hmm. Don't know what you're not used to it.
Yeah, no, I didn't say it was that fault. I'm with you guys.
So how far are you into your trip here? Is it
this is the fourth week.
Okay, so you still got
fourth week.
Still got a few months to go, don't you?
Yeah,
How's
man.
How's it going? Uh-huh.
So far, so good. It's been a lot of fun. We've
blink if you need a safe house. That way she won't hear you.
Yeah,
see?
We'll know. But
like the captain from the Pueblo.
Yeah, just blink in Morse code.
Yeah.
My own family members have taken a pool of at what part of the trip she's going to leave me and whose house she's going to end up at. So it's not me that needs a safe house.
We never knew that she liked Minot, North Dakota.
Yeah.
Sounds like a cool idea. Our guest, Dave Williamson, driving with his family across country. On the comedy tour. Christy Lee at the news desk, what haven't we heard about yet today?
Well, Tommy Lee has posted an open letter on Twitter and Facebook complaining about how much he hates taking photos with fans.
Mm.
Lee writes he loves his fans.
Peace and love.
Peace and love.
Yes, mm-hmm. But the fastest way to make him leave is to whip out a camera. He says fans should not care if people don't believe they met him unless they have a photo. As Lee puts it, and I quote, I'm not here to take pictures with you. I'm here to entertain you.
Oh, I see.
Yeah.
Okay. All right. Well, good luck to you.
So you spend your whole life going, look at me, look at me, look at me, look at me. Get away
not
from me.
Look at me.
You know, you ask for fame and you get it. Don't be a dick about it.
He finds it irritating when people say fans put him where he is because he says, nobody put me where I am but me.
Well, you're wrong there, Tommy.
Right.
You
bought all the albums.
Tommy entertained anybody.
Yeah.
Sorry, Tommy. Try again.
Yes.
And I have a Superman story.
Well, we'll come back with that.
I mean Spider-Man story.
We'll come back with Spider-Man.
Oh, there's a big difference.
All right. A huge difference.
I know.
A huge one.
I was looking at Superman on her shirt because I can't stop staring at her breasts either. And
this is my fantasy.
I was going to say,
true.
Hello, guys.
I'm staring too, but I didn't notice Superman was on there.
How could you miss?
Because I'm using my special invisible shirt glasses.
Look at you guys. We are. We'll
be back with Ariola and Steve.
Sorry, Chris.
Ario Speedwagon? No.
Oh, that's a band. Ariola Speedwagon. How did we never think of that?
I don't know.
Oh, my. I love that.
And they do the soundtrack to the Hard Times Soft Tacos. We'll be right back. This is the Bob and Tom Show. Welcome back to the Bob and Tom Show. More 80s tributes today because we have...
Flock of Seagulls, what's your name?
80s fan, Cristela Alonso. What's that from where he goes, you Flock of Seagulls?
Pulp Fiction.
Oh, that's me.
Oh, big Hawaiian burger, huh?
sorry. Did I break your concentration? Oh.
Here it comes.
I walk along the avenue. I never thought I'd meet a girl like you. Meet a girl like you.
Is this the only hit?
Oh,
yeah, they had
Sound
one
just
other.
Like this one.
Yeah. They all did sound very similar.
Didn't
it?
That's what the 80s was. You were only allowed to have one.
Oh,
hit,
right? Yeah.
This was early 80s.
Here's their other ones. There's Space Age Love.
Wait, here's the thing. Here's the hook.
Oh,
right?
Yes.
Come. Here it comes. And that's it. Okay.
Here's a question. Down. Which decade had the most one-hit wonders?
Oh. 60s?
I bet so. I bet the 60s. Because there were the cufflinks and the Chantels.
Oh, there were all kinds
the
of...
The cufflinks?
And the Levi's. Shut up, Christine. And...
Oh, the Levi's. I remember.
Remember the Levi's?
The cufflinks were huge.
Here's their other...
Wranglers.
Their other hit.
Okay. This is four guys named Siegel. A flock of seagulls.
Wait, man.
No. Oh,
no.
Like someone, yeah. Someone had to have been a band of flock of seagulls. But...
Is that a woman or a man? I can't tell.
Wow, does this stink on ice?
Yeah,
huh?
It does. Really, yeah. Really does.
By the way, chick, the cufflinks, of course.
Mm-hmm.
Or an American.
No way.
American band from Staten Island, New York.
From what?
Are you serious?
They did
what
have a
their,
hit.
What was their big hit?
I bet you can sing it.
Let me see
60s?
If I can find the cufflinks here.
The cufflinks?
Yeah.
Did you make that up off the top of your
yeah,
head?
Yeah, I did.
No, no.
Wow. You're good.
You know,
I do have the cufflinks.
And they had a big hit.
Oh, here, here. See if,
see if you can recognize it.
See if this is it.
Okay, stop. Know what it is?
Yeah.
Cindy, Jimmy, Jenny.
Stacy.
Stacy!
No.
Tracy! What you just heard, ladies and gentlemen, is Bob and Tom's show in 20 years when we're all sitting at the home.
Stacy, Maine, Philly!
Uh-huh. Don't you remember?
I remember Tracy.
What's her name? Was Waterford, the crystal girl. The water.
All of the vocals were actually done by Ron Dante.
Ron Dante.
Yes,
who's Barry Manilow's guy, right? Didn't he write a bunch of stuff or produce or something?
I think he was all the Archies and
he was the Archie.
He's one of those guys.
Except for Hot Dog. Hot Dog played the tambourine.
What?
Okay.
Yeah, Ron Dante was the lead singer of the fictional cartoon band The Archies. I blame you for
Sugar.
All of this.
Fictional? What?
Christella.
Christella on this? You're blaming her?
Yeah, because well, she got us playing all this all this 80s stuff.
Chick's the one who yelled out cufflinks.
Okay. I did yell out cufflinks.
Yeah.
Okay.
My God.
Now, we have a couple guests in the studio, but we have a bunch of stuff we have to do here first.
Mm-hmm. One-hit wonders have been spread out equally among the decades, but one would have to say the 70s had the most one-hit wonders.
Well.
Sorry to hear that.
Are we here?
We are here.
Okay. Thank you very much. Okay, let's move on here.
Time now for Things You Learned on today's Bob and Tom Show with your host, Tom. Here's Tom.
Chick has a new sound effect in his arsenal.
I do not.
Shotgun?
I do.
Yeah, the shotgun over there.
Some kind of gun.
Oh, yeah.
Okay, I did it for him.
Mm-hmm. Mr. McGee.
That doesn't sound like that.
Mr. McGee needs a new mouse.
Oh.
If Mr. McGee does get a new mouse, he's going to cry.
You're supposed to say walk.
There are talking urinal cakes to discourage drunken driving in Michigan. Mm-hmm. Apparently, when you pee on them, it reminds you to not drink and drive. I think nothing better than scaring a drunk guy with something talking back to his penis, which is in his hand.
Amen.
Let's see. We decided to skip the story about too much syrup because there was battering.
A lot of battering.
Christella has a great idea for a movie or TV show, Hard Times, Soft Tacos.
Mm-hmm.
And let's see. Alligators do not like the TV show Swamp People.
No.
Chick is going to start agreeing with me on everything.
Yes,
boring.
I am. I'm sorry. I'm not using the right voice.
Right you are, Tom. Anything you say, buddy. What are we going to do after the show?
I love the music.
All righty, boss.
I love the music of Johnny Rivers. See, Chick can't do it.
I mean, yes, sir. Johnny Rivers really rocks it. And what a nice guy he is.
I like Johnny. There's a wedding ring that apparently leaves the impression on your skins that says I'm married.
Mm-hmm.
So if you try to take the finger off,
I mean, the ring.
The wife will take the finger off.
Okay. Yeah. So this is a ring. This is a ring to keep guys from cheating.
Yeah, because once you take the ring off, so it still says I'm married.
So the lady has to look at your hand. Maybe they should put the ring somewhere else.
Oh my.
See, if wedding rings came with bottle openers, guys wouldn't take them off.
I can't believe I'm saying this. That's a great idea.
Brilliant idea.
I own one.
Let's see. Mark Wahlberg never actually met Ted while filming the movie.
Mm-hmm.
It was just some guy holding two paws. The fight scene in some reviews is saying it's the best fight scene ever. Mark Wahlberg told us Ted is a hard R.
Uh-huh.
Mm-hmm.
Swings hard. Dave Williamson does not wear a karate outfit on stage.
No.
Although he is considering it. Christella likes to make meals that take hours to prepare. She also likes to clean. Her boyfriend is a comedian. I'm surprised all of his buddies don't live at the house with him. Dave is currently driving an RV all across the country with his family. Chick has asked him to blink four times, then pause, then blink once if he needs a safe house.
That's right.
Christella is wearing a T-shirt that says Justice League on it. I did not notice that there was anything on her.
It's a big Superman there. Mm-hmm.
And we are creating a new band called Areola Speedwagon.
Why not?
The covers are going to be amazing.
Mm-hmm.
I'm looking forward to it very much. Check out the website. We've got a bunch of cool links there. This is the Bob and Tom Show. Edgar Winter calls Dave, hey, Whitey.
He's not that light.
It feels like high school all of a sudden.
It does, doesn't it?
High school? You're giving us that much credit? Thank you.
Oh, I know.
Usually we're labeled in the
fourth
second
grade.
Or third grade. Yeah.
Yeah.
It's mirroring my experience in high school.
We have Christy with a very hot weather forecast.
From which TV's forecast 8 on Q95. Excessive heat warning, more record heat, an air quality alert, slight chance for a storm, and a high of 101. Partly cloudy tonight, low 76. Still hot on Saturday, slight chance for a storm, high 97. Spotty storms on Sunday, partly cloudy and 96. Currently 90 degrees.
It truly sounds like the end of the world.
Yesterday, did your car have one of those thermometer things in the dash?
Yeah.
Mine had, yesterday, mine said 110 degrees.
Yeah, mine said 111.
Mine 106 was the highest I got. How high?
104.
Oh.
No, I'm sorry, 109 when I got in. And then it goes down because it's sitting in the...
I beat you guys. 168 was mine.
I think that was your radiator day.
I think the thermometer element might have fallen in your oil.
You may have been looking at the speedometer, Dave.
I sit on my mirror. Is that wrong?
I forgot to do this. Let's do it now. It's your girlfriend Jess's birthday.
Yes, happy birthday.
Happy
Jess.
Birthday. It's also there's some other birthdays out there.
Like who?
Well, I don't know.
Who else?
Comedian Tim Cavanaugh.
Cavanaugh's birthday?
Apparently is celebrating. No, he's got some birthdays, some celebrity birthdays. So let's check in.
Hey, Bob and Tom. It's time for Tim Cavanaugh's cavalcade of celebrity birthdays. I'm comedian Tim Cavanaugh. Turning 70 last week was Sir Paul McCartney. In a recent poll asking who is the most talented living Beatle, Paul got a whopping 85% of the vote.
Mm.
Ringo actually finished third, 2 points behind Ron Paul.
Ron Paul.
Turning 67 this week is singer and actress Deborah Harry. I was thinking, if she married Bruce Boxleitner, she'd be Deborah Harry Boxleitner. A happy 26th birthday to Lady Gaga, better known to postal workers by her postal name, Lady Georgia Georgia. Celebrating birthday number 35 this week is actress Liv Tyler.
Oh, wow.
If I didn't know that she was Steven Tyler's daughter, I'd probably find her attractive. But knowing what I know, the thought of kissing those lips, yeesh. Celebrating birthday number 37 is Tobey Maguire. It's a fact that he dropped out of school in the ninth grade, which explains his 2002 statement, Spider-Man was the hardest book I ever read. I could breeze through Archie and Jughead, but Spider-Man had bigger words like arachnoid, which I still don't know what it means. Singer-songwriter George Michael turns 49 this week. His first taste of fame came with his duo Wham, which is actually a shortened version of the duo's real name, Wham Bam Thank You Sir.
Oh.
So that wraps up another edition of Tim Cavanaugh.
Did you cut him off?
I didn't cut him off.
Tom did.
I thought I went deaf.
Mm-hmm. I did not. I don't know why it cut off like that. I apologize, Tim.
I blacked out.
Tim Cavanaugh is at Wiley's Comedy Club tonight and Saturday in Dayton, Ohio.
What are you doing after the show today?
And
I mean, why do you immediately ask? After the show.
Why do you why? Ask?
We could run and see Ted.
I cannot do that.
Of course you can.
I have a doctor's appointment at 11.
Can I go to your doctor's appointment?
Sure.
Can we just go to wait. The doctor with you? Can I go? Can I go, Tom?
Just sit down right here, sir. Yeah. No, are you going to go see Ted today?
I'm going to go see. I think I'm going to run and see Ted.
Okay. Yes. Good. Well, give us a full report. I may get to it this weekend. I'm not sure.
It's not really not really a girl movie, I don't think.
I think I'm going to go.
No, I don't think it is a girl movie.
Yeah, but I think I'm going to go.
Now, Dave, did you go see the Three Stooges movie?
No, I didn't. I haven't even heard that much about it, to be
honest.
I've
never been more lost in a movie theater in my life. I went to see the Three Stooges.
Oh, it came and went, right?
I mean, it's gone. People were laughing around me. And
yeah. My daughter still talks about that.
In a bad way?
Yes.
Oh, sorry.
No, you know, ladies don't like the Three Stooges.
Groucho Marx, Marx Brothers, I'm there all day.
Mm-hmm.
This was the Three Stooges remake, the recent one.
Mm-hmm. Did not do well.
The funniest part of the movie for me was the two guys that said they were the Farrelly Brothers at the end of the movie.
Oh, that was funny.
Yeah.
Yeah, I see. Well, let's. Did you have anything you had to do over there? Do I have to do something with you, chick, right now?
No. We'll do whatever you want to do, Tom. I ain't got nothing over here, though. I can tell you that.
Okay. Now, Dave Williamson is with us, and Dave is driving an RV across the country. And with your family in it, I should point that out.
Yes, so far they're still with me.
So you just park it anywhere?
Wife and two sons?
No, we park in, you know, campgrounds and state parks and relatives that thought that I would never come visit them.
Uh-oh. Hey,
you got an outlet I could borrow for
a couple
days?
Oh, my God, they're here.
Yeah. You have an extension cord?
Now, what's the rule? When you're at relative's house, do you use their toilet facilities or do you use the one on the RV?
Depends how long we're going to be there for, because if you're there for too long, the one in the RV will fill up. So you try to...
Now, is there some kind of a meter that tells you when it's ready to rock?
There is. It's called your nose.
Ah, there you go.
Is that simple, really?
No, there's a little meter. But
Now, do the bigger RV centers have a cleanup place or do they just hover over a bridge in Chicago?
I've done both, but... Yeah, they have a little, like, there's, like, this hole in the ground that just goes to somewhere you probably never want to find yourself.
I think it goes
just
to
plug into it. And you just
Saudi Arabia, which is where our oil comes from.
It's the American way, right?
You just park over the thing and let her rip?
You just put your hose into this little tank, and it just goes, and you never question where it ends up. You just know it's out of your rig.
And is there a fee?
Well, you pay the money to stay at the park, and then that usually comes with it.
Okay.
So there's no dumping fee.
Isn't it understood that you're not supposed to have a major transaction in one of those unless you absolutely have to?
Right?
Yeah, well, we're living in it, so we pretty much have to.
Mm-hmm. There you go.
But when you're on the road, you stop.
Can't you go to a truck stop?
You could.
That slows down. Yeah. I mean, come on, take the wheel, honey. I'm going to go back and make a sandwich and have a...
It's not that bad. I mean, it's the rule on a bathroom.
That's the rule on a boat.
If you guys want to pop out to the parking lot here and...
But you're not supposed to be in the back while the RV's moving, correct?
No, mine's a travel trailer, so we actually travel in a truck and then we tote the house behind us.
Oh, I see. Okay. All right.
So, they can't be in it then?
No. Well, they could, but I would probably get in trouble.
Mm-hmm.
From the...
So it's called a fifth wheel, I think. Is that what they're called?
Well, fifth wheel's... And I knew nothing about this stuff
a few months ago.
So don't look at me like I'm an expert. I just know what I... But, fifth
wheel... You will be in 3 months.
Yeah.
Tell us more, Hill Jack. What else you got?
Yes, sir.
A fifth wheel is different?
Fifth wheel's a little different from what I have. Fifth wheel, you put into a pickup truck, the bed of a pickup truck, kind of.
Mm-hmm.
It's a little
bigger,
more... mine's a travel trailer.
Oh.
So I have a...
like a little Airstream thing?
Exactly.
Yeah. Ah. Mm-hmm.
So very nice.
You should do that, Tom. You would do well. An RV across the country. Oh. Different city every night.
Now, our friend actor Jeff Daniels.
Mm-hmm. He does it.
Drives
he does that. Yes,
RVs
he does.
All the time. Mm-hmm. He's got a real big one. He's got a bus.
Yeah, I don't have what he's got, I'm sure.
As does the singer and songwriter who's just here. He has the license to drive.
Edwin McCain
has the special license to drive the full-size tour bus.
Wow. Mm-hmm.
Yeah, when I first concocted this whole idea, and it was just a glint in my eye, I didn't even think I'd ever pull it off, but I was speaking to an extremely successful, famous comic that I was at a wedding with. Mm-hmm. We were just chit-chatting, and I kind of told him I was thinking about doing something like this. And he goes, I've always wanted to do that. Mm-hmm. And I'm like, oh, yeah, what are you thinking? And he's like, get a big bus and maybe go for, 4 days with the family. I'm like, that's very different
four
from what
days.
I'm envisioning. You're not roughing it there, buddy. You're just not taking a plane that week, you know? I'm thinking about living in this little tiny space, and I can't believe it. Here we are a couple months later, and I'm doing it. I'm the American dream, people,
yes,
all right?
Yes, you are.
Dave Williamson is at Marty's Comedy Joint with Bob Biggerstaff.
Yeah, great dude. Very funny.
Mm-hmm.
Don't let Biggerstaff go into that thing.
No.
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 Yeah,
he
will foul it.
Okay. Mm-hmm. I see where you're getting at with all the toilet talk now.
Right.
Thank you. It's all been a warning.
Mm-hmm.
Okay. Cristela Alonso is downtown. At Crackers downtown. Did we cover everything, Cristela?
I think we did.
I think we're officially family now.
Yeah.
Okay, I wanted to mention that there's a cool event going on the campus of Butler University. It's called, of all things, 24 Hours of Booty. But it's a, as you can see, I've got a poster here, beautiful poster. Mm-hmm. It's all about...
Is this the big bike ride?
Yeah, this is a bike ride event. It's so far raised millions of dollars across the country. It's... Livestrong is one of the big sponsors. It's, of course, a charity event. For more information, if you're a bicyclist, you want to get involved in this, 24hoursofbooty.org. And the 24 is the numerals, 24. 24 Hours of Booty. Butler University, and it's going on starting today. 24 Hours of Booty. Find out more information, once again, at 24hoursofbooty.org. On the campus of Butler University, obviously, there'll be a lot of water available.
Yes, there will.
And to belabor the point, dogs, don't tie them to a tree today. Don't leave them out there in the sun.
Oh, I got to go, guys.
No, I know.
Not funny.
You think I'm
or
kidding, but...
Don't tie them to a bumper.
Yeah.
The poor little fella kept up for as long as I did.
I love that.
I tried.
I know you did.
I tried.
Where do kids fall in this equation?
Same rules.
They're pretty resilient.
Same rules.
Oh, yeah.
Mm-hmm.
Okay, thanks very much for joining us. And
thank you, Tom. Good job, buddy.
Oh, thank you. You're welcome. Do you have a bumper sticker on the back of your RV?
I have some sports teams stickers, but would you like to give me one? I'll put it on there.
Miami Heat?
I do have one on the back of my truck, a Miami Heat sticker. But I think I'm going to have to remove it as I get into certain regions of the country.
Have you noticed areas flipping you off for no reason?
Everyone signs their name to my car. It's the nicest thing. They're wishing me luck.
But you never you always tend to see like 5 or 6 bumper stickers on a car, not just one.
Mm-hmm.
Well, if you guys give me a Bob and Tom bumper sticker, it will be the first bumper sticker on the back.
It'll be from the 80s.
I don't think we have one.
No, I
heard something about coffee mugs earlier.
We have that.
We do?
When did we get those?
I've seen one.
I will duct tape the coffee mug to the back of my RV for you guys.
Fair enough.
Thanks very much. This is the Bob and Tom Show.